Hi everybody, I'm Michelle Carr and welcome to Your Delicious Life, where each week we take a look at life from a different perspective and we either learn something new or we get reminded of something that we already knew. So this past weekend was my birthday. Yes, we have a lot of birthdays in the summer in our family. Matt will finish us off with his birthday in September. And then I won't talk about any more birthdays till next summer. But this past weekend was mine. And of course, there's really kind people who post all sorts of lovely messages on Facebook. And it kind of makes you reflect on your year and what's happened. And one of the messages that I got was just that, kind of a posing a question about, you know, thinking back on how the year went and then planning for the year to come. So I got to thinking about it. And it is a great opportunity to think back on how the year's been and where I was a year ago compared to where I am now. So I thought I'd share a couple of those things with you guys. So last year in August, we were very close to doing the final house reveal for Shanna and her two daughters, Cadence and Addison. We had renovated their home for them, so there was a group of people. My husband and I have a program, Airdrie Angel, that was involved in this, but Shanna had a core group of friends that were also very involved in the process. In fact, they invited us to be a part of it as well with Airdrie Angel. And our whole goal with it was to completely renovate a home for Shanna and the girls because both girls have a disease called Friedreich's ataxia. And it attacks different parts of your body, but one of the problems is mobility. So having an accessible home for these girls was really important so that they would be able to maintain their dignity and their independence as they get older, and an accessible home would be the answer to that. So I was involved with that project and it was coming to a close last August. So I think we handed over the keys, I think it was August 18th or 19th last year. And we literally had a move that bus moment. We actually had one of the bus companies come out, park in front of the house. The girls came around the corner in the limo. They came out and there was an amazing crowd of people, friends and family and supporters and those that donated. And everyone yelled, "Move that bus!" And this huge coach moved out of the way and the girls saw their home for the first time. So it was a really cool experience to be a part of. So that was a year ago, and our Airdrie Angel program has continued to do really well. Just this past summer we actually passed the $100,000 mark for cash and gifts that we've given away to people in our community that need a hand up and are going through a difficult time through no fault of their own. So that's really exciting. We're up to 55 families. So as far as the giving back portion of my life, I feel like that has gone amazingly well over this last year, and I'm excited for the years to come because I know we'll continue to grow the program and do fun and amazing things within the community, because there's so many giving people in this community, you can't help but be a part of something that helps another person. So that's really fun. On a business note, last year I still had the U Weight Loss Clinic and I really didn't know where it was going to go. I was going through a program called Smart Start that is put on with Economic Development and the Airdrie Chamber of Commerce and a couple of other partners. And, you know, going through that really helped me sort of reflect on the business and where it was and what I wanted it to be, and to challenge myself to see if that was possible or not and what the best decision was. And so this time last year, I was really struggling with that, to find out if that's something that I should continue forward with. If I don't, what does that look like? Who does that affect? And it was a big challenge for me. And as you know, if you've been following the blog and whatnot, I ended up closing the business this past March. And this August, the lease for the space will be up. So when I compare a year ago to not really knowing what was going to go on with that business and what was going to happen, to a year later, I've made a decision. I can say that I feel good about how we managed it with our clients and doing our best to care for them as we close down the business. Both the employees that I had working there have gone on to do good things, are happy in their new jobs, which makes me feel good because I didn't want to leave them hanging. And now the space will officially be done. So that will kind of close that chapter. So that's definitely a complete change from last year. As far as personally, I would say, you know, kids just get older and bigger and more human-y. Is that even a word? But it's funny, the conversations that I can have with my kids and their thought process, that just changes as time goes on. So that's really exciting and fun. I'd say Matt and I continue to work on our relationship. Anyone who's in a committed relationship knows it takes work. And I'm really proud of us for continuing to make time to work on it, whether that is having wine nights together or date nights or just chatting with one another. It takes work, and I'm proud that our relationship has continued to do that. For myself, I've tried to make a conscious effort to make sure I do something for myself every week. And for me, that can be stuff like getting my nails done, or if I have a haircut, you know, or just having a coffee and reading a good book, or just some quiet time. I've mentioned before that one of my favorite things is to go into chapters on a rainy day and just wander around. And I was very fortunate to get some gift certificates from my family for chapters for my birthday. So I'm sort of waiting for a rainy day. Sorry guys, I know it's the summer and you probably don't want rain, but I'm sort of waiting for one so I can just go to chapters, get a Starbucks, and just wander around and flip through books for a couple of hours. But I'm trying to make a conscious effort to have some time in my week for myself, whether it's 20 minutes or 2 hours, it doesn't matter, but having that time. Health-wise, I'm happy with the way things are. In this last little while, I've kind of been challenging myself to do some different things because I'll kind of get in a routine of always going and doing the same workout video or going for the same walk or, you know, kind of get set in my way. So I've been challenging myself with going to a couple of spin classes, hoping to incorporate some classes at Orange Fitness come September once the kids are back in school. So yeah, just trying to always challenge myself. And whether it's in physical fitness or in learning by listening to new podcasts or reading different books, whatever it is, just always trying to grow and expand. And you never know where you might, you know, find new information or new insight on something. So for me, it's a lot of fun to try new things and meet new people in those situations and see how something might challenge me in a way I didn't expect before. Going back to the business side of things, since I have closed the clinic, I've been really focused on building michellecarre.com and letting people know that I do speaking engagements. I've done a couple over the past few months, and I'm really looking forward to doing more this fall, and I even have some stuff booked for 2018 already, which is really exciting. And something else that's coming up is a live workshop that I'm doing in November. And I want to tell you guys a little bit about this. One of the questions that was posed to me, or that was kind of incorporated on one of the Facebook posts for my birthday, was about planning for the next year. And I got to thinking about that as I was walking the dog this morning. And I thought, okay, well, when is that point where you start planning for the next year? Is it your birthday? Is it when you literally change ages that you plan for the next 12 months? Is it January when the calendar changes? Is it September when the kids go back to school? Is it your fiscal year end for your business? There's so many different ways to, you know, cut up the year or to determine a start point for something. And the live workshop that I'm doing is all about creating an opportunity to do just that. So the workshop is on November 4th. It's going to be here in Airdrie. And I'm going to have it at the Embrace Bridal event space, which is right downtown Airdrie, in the Embrace Bridal location. They have this great little venue there, which is going to be just beautiful and intimate and warm. I'm really excited about it. And in that workshop, we're going to actually do work, which I love. I've gone to conferences, I've gone to events, I've sat in sessions, and you don't always get a chance to do the work. You get a chance to take notes, to do work later, but you don't usually get a chance to actually take what's been taught to you, the lesson, the theory, the conversation that's just happened, and activate that knowledge. And that's what I want this workshop to be. So the whole workshop is going to be about clearing clutter mentally and thinking about where we need to do it physically. It's going to be about defining what success is for you. All of us define success differently. So this is an opportunity for you to actually have time to sit and think and visualize what success is for you and capture that in a few sentences. So you have a place to always go back to measure your decisions against, because if this is your definition of success and this is what you're working toward, you're going to know how you can measure everything against it going forward. Then we're going to talk about how to actually make it happen, because it's great to have this vision and this idea of what you want your life to be and how you define success. But if you don't have an actual plan to make it happen, things fall apart. So we're going to talk about how to take action, and whether it's daily tasks or weekly tasks or monthly, or it's projects, whatever it is, we're going to organize these thoughts and these things so that success isn't just a vision, it's something you're working toward. So when I was thinking about, okay, when do you sort of reevaluate things and get it going and reset for the next year? And the answer is whenever you want, really. It could be your birthday, it could be January 1st, it could be September 1st. It doesn't really matter when you choose, but the whole point of this workshop is to give you the tools to be able to do it whenever you want to. So I've strategically put it for November 4th because it is just before the new year, which is the most common time for people to kind of reevaluate and set some goals. But the tools that you learn in this can be applied at any time of year. So how do you get to this workshop? Well, it's only $97. If you go to my website under speaking and workshops, you'll see the links to the page for it there. But if you purchase the online program, you're not only going to get one free ticket to the workshop, you're going to get two. So the online program is $197, and then you're going to get two tickets, both valued at $97, for free. So it's a total 2-for-1 package, kind of a 3-for-1, and you can bring a friend to the event. And if you go through the program, the online program first, what it's going to do is it's going to give you a great foundation and a real clear understanding of what the live workshop's going to be about. But the live workshop is really going to be about giving you an opportunity to take action, because that can be a tough thing. We can do online courses, but we don't always take the action that we are taught in those courses. So this is a great way if you are someone who loves to learn at home, but maybe needs a bit of a kick in the pants. That's what the workshop will be able to do for you. And if you're someone who's just more of a hands-on, in-person learner, the workshop is a great option as well. So check out the website for more details and message me, email me. I'm happy to answer questions and give you clarification. For me, I know if I'm about to purchase an online program or a conference, I want to have as much information as possible so that I know it's the right fit. So I'm happy to answer any questions you have so that I can give you all the information that you need so you can make a decision that's right for you. Thanks so much for watching, you guys. I'm really excited to share some of the events of this past year. I'm really excited for what this next year has in store, and really excited to share this live event coming up for you. So the event is called Create Your Delicious Life. It's November 4th here in Airdrie. It's a Saturday. It's a 9 to 3 p.m. event, and it's going to be a great day. Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope you have a great week. We'll see you soon.